In this segment, we'll talk about the basis of how do we find eigenvalues of a square matrix. So if somebody's telling you that, hey, I want you to find the eigenvalue of a matrix A, then we already know that it has to satisfy this condition, that there has to be some eigenvector, some vector, column vector X, which is a non-zero. Keep in mind, it's a non-zero, because if it is zero, it's going to be satisfied for no matter what the value of lambda is. So you're looking at a non-zero column vector, which you multiply by A, turns out to be some scalar lambda times the column vector X. So what we want to do is we want to be able to find out, hey, what is this lambda? How do I find the eigenvalues of this square matrix? So what that means is that A times X minus lambda times X is equal to zero. That's a zero vector right there. So I get A times X minus lambda times I times X is equal to the zero vector. And what that means is that A minus lambda times I will be times X will be equal to the zero vector right here. And the reason why I multiplied this lambda by I is because if I multiply I by X, I get X itself, so there's nothing wrong with doing that. But the reason why I introduced this INT matrix there is because so that when I'm doing the subtraction here, that I'm doing the subtraction between the matrices of the same size. That allows me to do that. If I didn't do that, then I'll be subtracting lambda from A, which is not allowed because A is an n by n matrix and lambda is just a scalar. So then, if you look at this particular set of equations, so if somebody says, hey, I gave you a set of equations for which the right-hand side is zero, one of the solutions is zero itself. So X equal to zero is a solution to this set of equations, but what we started with was that, hey, X has to be non-zero so that we can call this lambda to be an eigenvalue. So the only way it is possible that you're going to get, so what that means is that this particular set of equations does not have a unique solution. Because if it had a unique solution, X equal to zero is one of the solutions, zero vector is one of the solutions, that would be the unique solution. So if we are saying that this one does not have a unique solution, the only way that is possible is that this whole coefficient matrix, which is A minus lambda I, not just A, but A minus lambda I, will have to be singular. So the determinant of A minus lambda I will have to be zero. What that means is that then this matrix right here, A minus lambda I, has zero determinant, means that it is singular, means that it doesn't have an inverse, and that's how we are going to be able to find lambda. So if you are able to solve this set of equations right here, determinant of A this equation here, determinant of A minus lambda I equals zero, then you have a solution. It's going to happen is that if A is a n by n matrix, so we're talking about the order of the matrix given n, what's going to happen is that when you find the determinant of this matrix right here, A minus lambda I, it's going to be turn out to be of this form. You're going to get lambda n plus c1 lambda raised by n minus 1 plus so on and so forth plus cn equal to 0. That's what you're going to get. The form of the expansion of this determinant of this matrix here is going to turn out to be of this form. So you're going to have a matrix, you're going to have a polynomial equation. You're going to have a polynomial equation, and the polynomial order of this polynomial equation will be n. So since we have nth order polynomial equal to zero, you're going to get n roots of that polynomial, and those will be the eigenvalues of the A matrix. And that's the end of this segment.